Beautiful Rosh Hashanah morning, you discover a couple who can sing like this, you keep them around for a while. It's not just a beautiful way to begin our Yontif service. We continue on page 166. O source of light and truth, creator of the eternal law of goodness, and of the impulse within us for justice and mercy, we pray that this hour of worship may be one of vision and inspiration. Help us to find knowledge by which to live. Lead us to take the words we shall speak into our hearts and our lives. We rise now for the call to worship.
This new year, we have a chance for newness within our hearts, a newness that can change the course of our lives. But with so much uncertainty comes change. As we stand at the threshold of a new year, we pray for the valor to face uncertainty, the courage to truly change what needs to be changed, and the faith to welcome the new spirit that is within, uniting us as one, as we sing the Shema together on page 170. Seated, we join together in the chanting of Ve'ahavta.
Ve'ahavta et Adonai Elohecha v'chol levavecha v'chol nafshecha v'chol me'odecha v'hayu hadevarim ha'ele asher anochi metzavecha hayom alevavecha ושיננתם לבניך, ודיברת בם, ושיבתך בביתך, ובלכתך בדרך, ובשוכבך ובקומך, וקשרתם לאות על ידך, והיו לטוטפות בין עיניך. וכתבתם על מזוזות ביתך ובשעריך Lemantis geruva asitem et ol mitzvotai, vitem kidoshim lelohechem. Ani Adonai Elohechem, asher hotzeiti etchem me'eretz Mitzrayim, liot lachem l'Elohim, ani Adonai Elohechem emet.
True and enduring, beloved and precious, awesome, good and beautiful, is this eternal teaching.
This truth we hold to be forever certain.
You abide through all generations, your name is eternal. Your throne stands firm, your sovereignty and faithfulness are everlasting. Lord our God, you redeemed us from Egypt. For this, the people who felt your love sang songs of praise to you. Who humbles the proud and raises the lowly, who frees the captive and redeems the oppressed. All praise to God Most High, the source of blessing. Like Moses and Israel, we sing to you this song of rejoicing.
Continue on page 174. Each generation has its path, each a vision of its own. Our mothers and fathers kindled light. A life unmarred by hate and war. Homage to the faithful who came before us. Honor to the generations of Israel, our people. Remember us unto life, O Sovereign, who delights in life, and inscribe us in the book of life, O God of life. Great is the eternal power at the heart of life, mighty the love that is stronger than death.
Faithful love gives life to all, and acts of grace restore our strength.
Life's harsh winds uproot the weak, its hard rains beat down upon our kin. Let those who stand support the falling, keep faith with those who lie in the dust. How good to redeem the ancient pledge, for joy to blossom in arid soil. Please be seated.
Amen.
Read together on page 176. Let us proclaim the sacred power of this day. It is awesome and full of dread. For on this day your dominion is exalted, your throne established in steadfast love. There in truth you reign. In truth you are judge and arbiter, counsel and witness. You write and you seal, you record and recount. You remember deeds long forgotten. You open the book of our days, and what is written there proclaims itself, for it bears the signature of every human being. The great shofar is sounded, the still small voice is heard. The angels, gripped by fear and trembling, declare in awe, this is the day of judgment, for even the hosts of heaven are judged, as all who dwell on earth stand arrayed before you, as the shepherd seeks out his flock and makes the sheep pass under his staff. So do you muster and number and consider every soul, setting the bounds of every creature's life and decreeing its destiny.
More.
Magnum avirin et rolag zera.
Ut shuva, ut fila, ut sedaka. Mavirin, mavirin, et
Repentance, prayer, and charity temper judgment's severe decree. On 178. This is your glory. You are slow to anger, ready to forgive. It is not the death of sinners you seek, but that they should turn from their ways and live. Until the last day you wait for them, welcoming them as soon as they turn to you. Our origin is dust, and dust is our end. Each of us is a shattered urn, grass that must wither, a flower that will fade, a shadow moving on a cloud passing by, a particle of dust floating on the wind, a dream soon forgotten. Please rise.
Kishem shemakishim oto bishmemarom kakatu valiyar nevyecha vekarazel zeve amar.
As we are seated and continue with silent prayer, we would like to call to the Bima all the participants of the Torah service.
Yehu le'ratzon
We turn now to page 120 for the Torah service. I invite Nancy Solway to come forward to lead us in the Torah service. Mark Goodman and Aaron Bass will serve as Hagba and Galila for this service.
Ein kamocha ve'elohim Adonai, ve'ein kama'asecha. Malchutaha, malchut kol olamim, lamemshataha, bacholdor vador. Adonai melech, Adonai malach, Adonai imloch, leolam va'ed. Adonai oz le'amo itain, Adonai yivarech, etamo vashalom.
Together on page 121 for Avinu Malkeinu. Avinu Malkeinu, hear our voice. Avinu Malkeinu, we have sinned against you. Avinu Malkeinu, have compassion on us and on our children. Avinu Malkeinu, make an end to sickness, war, and famine. Avinu Malkeinu, make an end to all oppression. Avinu Malkeinu, inscribe us for blessing in the book of life. Avinu Malkeinu, let the new year be a good year for us. Avinu Malkeinu, fill our hands with blessing. Avinu Malkeinu, be gracious and answer us, for we have little merits. Treat us generously and with kindness and be our help.
Avinu Malkeinu. Malkeinu,
Eternal One, the Eternal God is merciful and gracious, endlessly patient, loving, and true, showing mercy to thousands, forgiving iniquity, transgression, and sin, and granting pardon. O house of Jacob, come let us walk by the light of our God. And as we go forth, let us say together the watchword of our faith. Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad. Hear, O Israel, Adonai is our God, Adonai is one.
This morning's Torah portion comes from the book of Genesis, from the story called the Akedah, the Binding of Isaac, and you may follow along in your prayer book on page 124 and 25 in the Hebrew and the English. For the Torah blessings, we call Audrey Clayman, and for the reading of the Torah, we call Carl Corman, Haley Sakwa, and Danny Singer.
Baruch Hu Adonai Hamvarach.
Baruch Adonai Hamvarach Le'olam Ba'ed.
Baruch Adonai Hamvarach Le'olam Ba'ed. Baruch Atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Bachar Banu Mikol Ha'amim V'Natan Lanu Et Torato. Baruch Atah Adonai Noten HaTorah.
Amen.
Amen. Vayehi achar hadivarim ha'ele ve'ha'elohim nisa et Avraham vayomer elav Avraham vayomer hineni vayomer kach na et bincha et yechidecha asher ahavta et yitzchak v'lech lecha el eretz hamoriah v'ha'alehu sham le'ola al achar heharim asher omar elecha. Vayashkem Avraham baboker vayachavosh et hamoro vayikach et shenei ne'arav ito ve'yitzchak beno vayvaka atzei ola vayakom vayelech el hamakom asher amar lo ha'elohim. Bayom hashlishi vayisa Avraham et einav vayar et hamakom merachok. Vayomer Avraham el ne'arav shavu lachem po im hachamor va'ani v'hana'ar nelecha ad ko v'nishtachave v'nashuva alechem. Vayikach Avraham et atzei ha'ola vayasem al Yitzchak bino vayikach beyado et ha'esh ve'et ha'ma'achelet vayelechu shneihem yachdav.
Vayomer Yitzchak al Avraham aviv, vayomer avi, vayomer hineni beni, vayomer hine ha'esh ve'ha'etzim, ve'ayeh ha'seh le'ola. Vayomer Avraham Elohim, yir Eloh ha'seh, Le'ola beni, vayilchu shenehem yachdav, vayavohu al hamakom, asher amar lo ha'elohim, vayiven sham Avraham et hamizbeach, vayaaruch et ha'etzim, vayaakod et Yitzchak beno, vayasem oto al hamizbeach mima al ha'etzim. Vayishlach Avraham et yado Vayikach et hama'achelet lishchot et beno. Vayikra elav malach Adonai min hashamayim vayomer Avraham. Avraham, vayomer hineni. Vayomer al tishlach yadcha el hanar ve'al ta'as lo me'uma. Ki ata yadati. Ki yir'eh Elohim ata ve'lo chasachta et bincha et yechidcha mimeni.
Vayisa Avraham et einav vayar vihine ayil ahar nechas basevach bikarnav vayelech Avraham vayikach et ha'ayil vayalehu leola tachat bino. Vayikra Avraham shemakom hahu Adonai yir'eh asher ye'amer hayom behar Adonai yira'eh. Vayikra malach Adonai el Avraham shenit min hashamayim. Vayomer bi nishbati ni'um Adonai ki ya'an asher asita et hadavar hazeh velo chasachta et bincha et yechidecha ki varech avarechecha v'harba harbeh et zarecha kikochavei hashamayim v'chachol asher al sfat hayam v'yirash zarecha et she'ar oyevav v'hitbarechu v'zarecha kol goyei ha'aretz eikev asher shamata b'koli vayashov Avraham el ne'arav vayakumu vayelechu yachtav al be'er shava vayeshev Avraham b've'er shava.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher natan lanu Torah emet v'chayei olam nata b'tochenu. Baruch atah Adonai noten ha-Torah.
Amen.
Please rise in honor of the Torah. Seated. We turn now to the Haftarah for this day. We turn back in our prayer books to page 198, 99, for the Haftarah, we invite Judy Schramm for the blessings and Mitch Mondry to read from the Book of Prophets.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam Asher bachar bin v'im tovim V'ratzav divrehem ha-ne'marim be'emet Baruch atah Adonai Habocher b'Torah Uv'Moshe avdo Uv'Yisrael amo Uv'invei ha-emet But said,
Amen. Seek the Eternal One while there is still time. Call out while God is near. Let the wicked forsake their ways, and the sinful their thoughts. Let them return to the Eternal One, who will show them compassion, to our God, who is quick to forgive. For my thoughts are not like yours, nor are your ways like mine, says the Eternal One. For high as the heavens above the earth, so are my ways high above your ways, and my thoughts above your thoughts. Just as rain and snow come down from the sky without returning, but water the earth, making it blossom and bear fruit, yielding seed for sowing and bread to eat, so it is with the word that comes from my mouth. It does not return to me unfulfilled, without having accomplished my desire and achieved what I send it to do. For you shall go out in joy. You shall be led forth in peace. Before you, mountains and hills shall break out in joyous song, and all the trees of the field shall clap their hands. Cypresses shall grow instead of thorn bushes, myrtle instead of briar. These shall be a monument to God, an everlasting sign that will stand firm.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam Tzur kol ha'olamim Tzadik b'chol hadorot Ha'el ha'ne'eman Ha'omer v'yoseh Ha'medaber u'mekayem Shekol d'ravav Emet v'tzedek Al ha'torah V'al ha'avodah V'al hanvi'im V'al yom hazikaron hazeh Shenatata lanu Adonai Eloheinu L'chavod ultifaret Al hakol Adonai Eloheinu anachnu modim lach Umavarachim otach Yitbarach shimcha Bafi kol chai tamid le'olam va'ed Udvar har emet v'kayam la'ad Baruch atah Adonai Melech kol ha'aretz Mikadesh Yisroel V'yom hazikaron.
We turn now in our prayer books to page 218 as we call Susan Norris and Sam Schiffer for special prayers for our congregation.
Eternal God, we pray to you for the whole house of Israel, scattered over the earth, yet bound together by a common history and united by a common heritage of faith and hope. Be with our brothers and sisters whose lives are made hard because they are Jews. Give them strength to endure and lead them soon from bondage to freedom, from lightness to dark. Bless this holy congregation and all who serve it, together with all other holy congregations in all lands near and far. Uphold us, shield us, and bestow upon us abundant life and health and peace and happiness in all our dwelling places. Bring to fulfillment the blessing of Moses, The Eternal, your God, make you 1,000 times as many as you are and bless you as God has promised you. Amen.
O God, send your healing to the sick, your comfort to all who are in pain or anxiety, your tender love to the sorrowing hearts among us. Be their refuge through their time of trial as they pass from weakness to strength, from suffering to consolation, from lonely fear to the courage of faith. Amen. We pray for all who hold positions of peace and stability in our national life. Let your blessings rest upon them and make them responsive to your will, that our nation may be to the world an example of justice and compassion. Deepen our love for our country and our desire to serve it. Strengthen our power of self-sacrifice for our nation's welfare. Teach us to uphold its good name by our own right conduct. Cause us to see clearly that the well-being of our nation is in the hands of all its citizens. Imbue us with zeal for the cause of liberty in our own land and in all lands, and help us to keep our homes safe from strife and war. Amen. We pray for the land of Israel and its people. May its borders know peace, its inhabitants tranquility, and may the bonds of faith and fate which unite the Jews of all lands be a source of strength to Israel and to us all. God of all lands and ages, answer our constant prayer with the Zion once more aglow with light for us and for all the world, and let us say, Amen.
Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt God's name together.
God El Adonai Ti, Rove Vashemo Yachedav.
We turn to page 211 and invite Justin Applefield forward to the Bima.
Shalom,
Tikia. Shivarim Terua. Tikia. Tikia. Shivarim. Tikia. Tikia. Terua. Tikia.
Continuing on page 213. Your love is everlasting to those who revere you. Your righteousness continues to children's children, to those who keep your covenant, who remember your commandments and do them. I remember your kindness, your great goodness to the house of Israel. The eternal God is a God of compassion, who will not forget the sworn covenant with your fathers and mothers. I will meditate on your precepts and keep your ways before my eyes. Justice, justice shall you follow, that you may live. Baruch Ata Adonai Zocher Habrit. Praised be the eternal God who remembers the covenant.
Tikia. Shivarim Terua. Tikia. Tikia. Shivarim. Tikia. Tikia. Terua. Tikia.
To mind the great moment when Israel stood at Sinai and heard the voice of the shofar. There are people entered into your covenant to be your witness to the world. From there they went forth to proclaim the laws by which the free may live and the enslaved find hope. That covenant we renew when we hear the sound of the shofar. From that day to this have we, a people acquainted with miracle and disaster, encountered you again and again on the path of our life. And you are present, O Eternal One, not on peaks of vision alone. At any moment we may turn and find you. The whisper of a thought, the most humble touch of being may lead us to you. So endlessly revealed amidst your concealments,
You stand awaiting our search to lead us with many a fall upwards to heights we tremble to climb.
This we hear, and the voice of the shofar, stranger among sounds, is heard.
And that shofar sound heralds yet another day, whose promise is our hope. Then shall begin the time of peace of which we dream. A world of truth shall be revealed to us, and together we shall rejoice in the sovereignty of God. Distant the goal, at time it fades from sight. For we are free, free to love, free to build, free to hate, free to tear down. And yet the dream is not forgotten, the vision does not fail. It is the meaning of our lives. Come what may, we shall hold fast to it. And even when the hope seems lost, we shall say, the dominion of heaven could begin today if we would but hearken to God's voice.
The great trumpet will sound, summon us to serve under your banner of truth, of purity, and of peace.
On that day, the great shofar shall be sounded.
Shofar to be sounded, proclaim liberty throughout the earth to all its inhabitants.
Happy is the people that knows the joyful sound.
They shall walk through the light of your presence.
And it shall be said on that day, this is our God for whom we wait, whose deliverance we await in hope. Every valley shall be exalted, every mountain and hill made low. The uneven ground shall be made level, and the rough places a plain.
The glory of the Eternal shall be revealed, and united all shall see it, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken.
Shout joyfully to the Eternal One, all the earth. Break forth, sing aloud, shout praise.
With trumpet sound and shofar blast, claim the sovereign God.
Baruch Ata Adonai, Shomea Kol Turat Amo Yisrael Berachamim. We praise you, the merciful God, who hearkens to the sound of the shofar.
Tekiya! Shevarim Teruwa! Tekiya! Tekiya, Shevarim. Tekiya, Tekiya, Teruah. Tekiya Gedola.
Yontif. Hundreds of years ago, on the island of Formosa, the people would offer human sacrifices to placate their many gods. That is, until a wise ruler named Goho decreed that only animals, not humans, were to be sacrificed. Soon thereafter, however, a terrible drought hit, and the crops failed completely. Once again, the people clamored for a human sacrifice. Very well, said Goho. To tomorrow morning at dawn, go into the forest. There you will find your victim tied to a tree and wearing a red robe. Early in the morning, the men rose with their clubs, and finding their sacrifice just as Goho had described, rushed forward and slew him. But when they pulled the red robe aside and uncovered his face, they were horrified to discover that it was Goho, their own beloved ruler. Never again were human sacrifices offered on Formosa, and the red robe, which devotees still wear to this day on the island now known as Taiwan, became a symbol of a changed life. Now, this is how the story of the Akedah, or the binding of Isaac, which we just read here on this Rosh Hashanah day, should have gone. God asks Abraham to sacrifice his son, his only son, Isaac, on Mount Moriah, and like Goho, Abraham stands up and says, "No, God, take me instead. I will sacrifice myself, but not my son." Instead, Abraham wakes up early, which the rabbis read as eagerly, saddles his donkey, and takes Isaac up to the mountain which God had shown him. What makes this even more perplexing is that this is the very same Abraham who had had the chutzpah to stand up to God and say, "You may not destroy the people of Sodom and Gomorrah." And they were perfect strangers, or rather, incredibly imperfect strangers, absolute sinners, in fact. Rashi, the biblical commentator, posits that Abraham's willingness to sacrifice his son is the ultimate test of his faith, a test he passes with flying colors. But archaeology has presented yet another intriguing possibility. You see, in one of the three valleys that make up the city of Jerusalem, Gei Hinnom, or the Valley of the Damned, my archaeology professor, Dr. Avraham Biran, uncovered Canaanite altars surrounded by clay urns whose contents offer grisly evidence that the pagans of that time did indeed sacrifice their children. And so, when Abraham had the religious epiphany of meeting the one God, the first inclination that he had was to do exactly what his neighbors would do, sacrifice a child to the God with whom he had spoken. But this God was not like those pagan gods. And so an angel, a heavenly messenger, tries to stop Abraham mid-swing by yelling, "Abraham!" And then when that did not work, "Abraham!" Finally, at the very last moment, Abraham awakes from his fog, looks up, and sees a ram caught in a thicket. In this light, you see, Abraham actually fails God's test. He responds to a religious moment as a pagan would. And the story of the Akedah is actually God's way of letting us know that we are not pagans. We are Israelites. We are Jews. And Jews do not sacrifice our children. And yet, I do sometimes worry that we have not yet fully learned this lesson. This past summer, Pope Francis issued an encyclical on global warming. Now, I don't want to spend the entire morning debating whether or not the Pope and the President and NASA and the climate change scientists are correct or incorrect on this specific ecological issue. Instead, here is the single question I have for you as parents and grandparents. As a parent or future parent, can you afford to take the chance that even one more species is chased off the face of the earth by human intervention? For that one species of plant may one day yield the cure for cancer or diabetes or autism. And if it were your particular child suffering from that particular disease, what would your answer be? What could your answer be? Can we as parents afford to take the chance that even one more species of animal is poisoned or crowded into extinction? For what if it is an insect, like the lowly bee, whose miracle of pollination sustains our crops and thus our lives? If we lose just one important species, we may be sacrificing the bounty of our children's future. It is time, my friends, for us to wake up from our fog, or should I say smog, put aside petty partisanship, and get started on creating a cleaner, more biologically diverse, sustainable world. For we are Jews, and Jews do not sacrifice our children. I worry, too, that we risk sacrificing our Jewish children to assimilation and apathy. If we do not heed the warning of so many recent reports and studies which reveal that millennials must be approached in new and innovative ways, we risk losing a generation. It is not that they don't care about Judaism. They do. What is true is that they relate to institutions and membership differently than did their parents and grandparents. I am happy to report to you, however, that we at Temple Israel are not standing idly by in the face of this potential sacrifice. With the help of a very generous benefactor and friend, we have given birth to The Well, a spiritual, educational, and social action meeting place for young and under-affiliated Jews. It will be spearheaded by Rabbi Dan Horowitz. Although Dan will not be serving as a pulpit rabbi here at Temple per se, I have asked him to join us on the Bima this morning so that you can get to know him and perhaps connect him to young adults in your family or among your friends. Perhaps even join him tomorrow afternoon, people of all ages, at 5:30 in Hart Plaza downtown for the first ever Rosh Hashanah Rush Hour, a Tashlik ceremony in which participants will be asked to cast their sins upon the waters of the Detroit River. Please pick up a few of these business card flyers, which are on the table as you exit, and hand them out to anyone at your dinner tables this evening who might be interested. Why is it called The Well? Our ancestors were a desert people, and thus their lives centered around the community well. For them, The Well was a meeting place, a business center, a singles bar, a lifeline, a coffee klatch, the water office cooler, and the office water cooler, and a place to just hang out and schmooze. The Well's underlying premise is that Jewish worship, values, ethics, and spirituality can and should be directly applicable to our lives and to the lives of our children. I know that you will welcome Dan warmly into our Temple family as we wish him the greatest success in raising the tide of Jewish engagement here in metropolitan Detroit and at Temple Israel. Finally, as the old fogey and Luddite that I most certainly am, I worry that we risk sacrificing our children to the God of technology. I don't know what to do about it, mind you. I am as attached to my cell phone as anyone else, although to this point I don't actually tweet. But I worry about the long-term effects of being so constantly and remotely connected to so many other people at the same time, all the time. Recently, I sat down with one of our teens at a youth event and realized that she was texting with another teen two tables over. So there they were, with magical devices in their hands that send signals 1,000 miles into space to bounce off a satellite orbiting the Earth, only to be beamed down 6 feet over. It's like the world's skinniest triangle, you know? I mean, even the satellite has got to be looking down saying, "Come on, kids, just get up and talk to each other." As parents, don't we know in our kishkas that this new Facebook, Twitter, texting, Instagram, Netflix, Hulu, Snapchat, Xbox world we are enabling for them is unhealthy, or at the very least, problematic? In addition to the lack of personal connection, the alienation, the distraction, and the physical inactivity that these devices foster, they can actually be life-threatening, as evidenced by the fact that my daughter's car was recently rear-ended by a driver who was so distracted that he never even hit the brakes before piling headlong into a line of 6 automobiles stopped on the highway. She is okay, thank God, but as a parent, you never want to get that phone call. And yet, although we are aware of the risks, we feel helpless in the face of this onslaught of technological change. I feel helpless and have no real or effective remedy to offer, except to say that no one has ever been hurt by forging deeper personal connections with family members around a holiday table. Rosh Hashanah is a perfect opportunity to talk with our mouths and with our hearts, but without our cell phones, with those we love. No one has ever remained uninspired while spending time in and protecting God's glorious natural splendor, the creation of which we celebrate on this very day of Rosh Hashanah. And no one has ever remained spiritually thirsty while drinking deeply from the life-affirming waters of Judaism, as our ancestors did at the well, their communal and spiritual meeting place. So, although our robes on these high holy days are white instead of red, let this too be a year in which our lives are changed. For we are Jews, and like the people of Formosa, and like Abraham in our Torah portion, we do not, we will not, we must not ever again sacrifice our children. And let us say,
thank you.
remind you to send us the addresses of your children who are away at college. We request that you take Yad Ezra bags so that you may bring them back on Yom Kippur filled with food. And we look forward to continuing this beautiful service as we turn to the Aleinu on page 222. Please rise. And death alike are mysteries. We journey through a country dimly seen by the uncertain light of thought and feeling, and death is undiscovered territory, a land without report. Yet, as we now remember our loved ones who have died, we look ahead with faith and hope. They have faded from our sight, but they live on in God's presence, where nothing good can perish. In the eternal, all beauty shines forever. As we turn from thoughts of death to tasks of life, may we, like those who came before us, be builders of God's kingdom, a world of justice and of joy. We join in the Kaddish. Yitgadal v'yitgadash shemei rabbah, v'alma divra chirutei v'yamlich malchutei, v'chayechon v'yomechon, V'chaye dechol Beit Yisrael, ba'agala uvizman kariv imru, amen. Yehei shmei rabah mevorach leolam olmei olmaya, yitvarach v'yishtabach v'yitpa'ar v'yitromam v'yitnase, v'yitadar v'yitale v'yitalal shmei dekudisha brichu, li'ela min kol birchata v'shirata, Tushbachata v'nechamata, damiran b'alma v'imru, amen. Yehei shlomo rabba min shemaya, v'chayim aleinu v'al kol Yisrael v'imru, amen. Oseh shalom v'imromav, hu yaaseh shalom, aleinu v'al kol Yisrael v'imru, amen. May the source of peace send peace to all who mourn and comfort to all of those who are bereaved among us. And let us say, amen.
So our service concludes. We join together in the singing of Ein Keloheinu on page 225.
Oh,
blessing for love and for all the good things that we hope for ourselves and those who are part of our family, our congregation, and our community. Amen.